the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Show the light of your truth to those who go astray, so that they may return to the right path. Give all who, for the faith they profess, are accounted Christians, the grace to reject whatever is contrary to the name of Christ, and to strive after all that does it honor. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Let us be seated for the readings.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Amaziah, priest of Bethel, said to Amos, "Off with you, visionary! Flee to the land of Judah. There earn your bread by prophesying, but never again prophesy in Bethel, for it is the king's sanctuary and a royal temple." Amos answered Amaziah, "I was no prophet, nor have I belonged to a company of prophets. I was a shepherd and a dresser of sycamores. The Lord took me from following the flock and said to me, 'Go prophesy to my people, Israel.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, Let us see your kindness and grant us your salvation. I will hear what God proclaims, the Lord, for he proclaims peace. Near indeed is his salvation to those who fear him, glory dwelling in our land. Kindness and truth shall meet, justice and peace shall kiss. Truth shall spring out of the earth, and justice shall look down from heaven. The Lord himself will give his benefits. Our land shall yield its increase. Justice shall walk before him and prepare the way of his steps. A reading from Ephesians. The letter is St. Paul. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavens, as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world to be holy and without blemish before him. In love, he destined for us for adoption to himself through Jesus Christ, in accord with the favor of his will, for the praise of the glory of his grace that he granted us in the beloved. In him we have redemption by his blood, the forgiveness of transgressions, in accord with the riches of his grace that he lavished upon us. In all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, in accord with his favor that he set forth in him as a plan for the fullness of times, to sum up all things in Christ in heaven and on earth. In him, we were also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intention of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory, we who first hoped in Christ. In him, you also, who have heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and have believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, which is the first installment of our inheritance toward redemption as God's possession, to the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. Jesus summoned the 12 and began to send them out two by two and gave them authority over unclean spirits. He instructed them to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts. They were, however, to wear sandals, but not a second tunic. He said to them, "Wherever you enter a house, stay there until you leave. Whatever place does not welcome you or listen to you, leave there and shake the dust off your feet in testimony against them." So they went off and preached repentance. The 12 drove out many demons, and they anointed with oil many who were sick and cured them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise
to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good afternoon. Boy, I almost said morning. That would have been embarrassing. But it is indeed a good afternoon as we come here in God's house to celebrate this holy sacrifice of the Mass. And I know for some of us, it's the first time back since COVID. And how beautiful for us to be back together with God's family on this most beautiful and glorious Sunday. Now, our readings today are very prophetic in that they challenge us to go out and to bear the good news of Jesus Christ. But they do so in a very unique and particular way that I think bears a little bit of reflection. This whole call of Jesus and the 12 to go out, but to go out with simplicity of spirit, to take nothing for the journey but a walking stick, no food, no sack, no money in their belts, to get back to the basics, so to speak. Now, one of the unique challenges of priestly ministry is that from time to time, we are called to move. And throughout the past couple of decades, I've been doing quite a bit of moving. Whether it was that happy day when I was just 18, leaving my folks behind, heading off to college, or whether it was in the seminary and each summer I was sent this way and that way for one program, missionary experience, or service, or another, or even as a priest to spend 2 years in Wausau, 2 years in La Crosse, 3 years in Rosholt, and Bishop, if you're listening, many, many, many years in Stevens Point. But with each move, I am reminded of how much stuff we accumulate, or at least I do. Now, a good chunk of the accumulation is books. This, that, or the other thing that have somehow moved my heart, and I wish to save it so as to be able to return to it if I need it for another thought, another homily, another a discussion later on. Some are, you know, those books I've been meaning to get to, and then there's another shelf of books that are kind of those which I like to give away. When I meet someone, when a particular circumstance or another, to be able to share with them a book that has helped me through different times within my own life. Then another section of the packing are those, you know, necessities for daily life. You know, that's where the clothing, the shoes, the socks, all that lovely stuff. But I am amazed at every time I move, how much stuff I buy, not for the here and now, but for the future. Because there might be some sort of a future need or a future want, and you see it at the store, you stumble at it online, and you just say, hey, that would be a nice thing to add to the collection. I have a calligraphy set that I have owned for many years. I have never opened it, but someday, you know, I might take that up. I can't let that go. I'm sure if we all think of our own possessions, we can think of those closets, those attics, those basements. Some of us might even have rooms of stuff that we're holding on to just in case we need it later. Just in case we need it later. I think that Jesus is reaching out to his apostles to tell them it's not about later. It's about now. We are created not to live in the future, but to live in this present moment now. To be able to live in union with Christ and to bring his message of love to those around us. And if there's anything that we're clinging on to in this world that's weighing us down, whether it's our worry of our pocketbook, whether it's the worry of our health, whether it's the worry of a loved one, all of these things are not bad. But they should not stop us from the greatest good, which is to live in union with Christ. And if we are able to live in that union, to place our trust in God that he will give us the things that we need, then we can indeed live our lives with tremendous joy. May we be worried about what's in our hearts and not what's in our wallets. May we be worried about how we reach out to others and not how others judge our clothing. May we spend our time and our energy building up relationships of love and not scouring the internet for another good deal, another collectible, another thing we couldn't possibly live without, another thing we didn't know we need until we saw it. Today, Jesus asks us to set all of that aside, to love, to live, to share. May God bless you today. always. Rising before our Lord, thankful for the gifts and blessings that God has entrusted to us, let us pray together what it is that we believe. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Thankful for the many gifts and blessings that God has given us, let us bring forth our prayers of petition. For the Pope, bishops, and priests, that they may govern the Church with wisdom and serve the faithful with Christ's love, we pray to the Lord. That Christ may guide the minds of all civil leaders as to promote the common good according to God's will, we pray to the Lord. That our parish will be a vibrant community of prayer, evangelization, and charitable action, we pray to the Lord. For the grace to be completely dedicated to Christ and to remain faithful to our Christian vocation, we pray to the Lord. For the school sisters of Notre Dame who are celebrating their Jubilee in 2021, that the Lord may bless those who have generously served the church, we pray to the Lord. For the intentions inscribed in our book of prayer, in our prayer baskets, and lifted to Jesus in the quiet of our heart, we pray to the Lord. For all of our beloved dead, especially Carol Hintz, and the intention of this Mass, Terry Sena, we pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we, your beloved children, lift these prayers up to you through Christ our Lord. my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim. By sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. The Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just a few prayer requests this week. Please pray for Father Doug Robertson. He's celebrating 25 years of priest tomorrow, so that'll be a joyous celebration. He's currently the pastor at Our Lady of Peace in Marshfield. When I was a kid, we called OLP our local prison, but it's a wonderful church. But anyways, I'll be heading out there tomorrow afternoon to celebrate with him. Keep Father Todd in your prayers. He's heading off for a little vacation next week, so we won't see much of him, but may it be restful and relaxing that he'll be returned strengthened to us. And may we keep each other in our prayers, that as we continue through this most unusual time, that we may all have the courage to bear the good news, share the light and the love of Jesus Christ. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace.